What I've seen as a therapist in my practice is that fear usually doesn't lead to respect. What we have observed closely is parents openly admit that corporal punishment doesn't always promote adherence to rules. It simply makes them better at breaking them.
There are parents who use physical punishment, there are parents who do not use physical punishment, and we do not see that the parents who are using physical punishments are making their children any better than the people who are not using it. So it simply means that there are ways.
Reward and consequences can be one of the best ways to gain respect and control over your child's behavior. Unfortunately, many parents fail at this. What we need to do here is we need to make two separate lists. One, to promote the behavior you want in your child, and the one you want to work on in decreasing.
Reward does not mean that you have to bribe them, that I'll give you this if you do this. It may be simple verbal appreciation that, okay, I like you did this.
We are so focused in helping them develop that sometimes we forget that we need to let them play for the sake of playing also at times. We need to remember that this is their childhood and they should be able to do things they love to do as kids and enjoy to the fullest intent possible.
We have to make the learning interesting. We have to involve all the senses that can be involved, like seeing, touching, or hearing about the things, or experiencing things, being tactile. So different senses should be involved in learning, and we have to take into consideration the age of the child also.